reason, and it talks about abstinence, but it comes from a very unique point of view. It talks about a girl who has been living in a lifestyle that is not pure and is not holy. And in this lifestyle, she's not a Christian, but then something happens where, you know, somebody leads her to Jesus and she becomes a Christian and then has to then decide, you know, which life she's going to live, because as we know, being a Christian isn't just praying a prayer, but it's living a lifestyle. And, you know, I think it's a song that all of us can relate to on any level, whether you've actually been through that situation or not, because we all know what it feels like to have to give something up that you really love for God. Absolutely, there's no option but to give it up, and you have to do it God's way or you'll never be happy. Growing up, I just thought I was the ugliest thing in the world. There were times when I was overweight, and I'm always fluctuating, you know. And I had braces, I had all these acne medications that I went on. I don't always eat the best. I'm not the healthiest eater. I'm convinced to this day that my face is uneven, which I know people. So that's definitely something I've always dealt with, is just being 5 or 10 pounds overweight, and you know, just always trying to lose that, and then, you know, losing it and then gaining it back again. I mean, I know how it feels to not get your pants on, and that just, it really stinks.
We just thought it would be really cool to have a song that really dealt with self-esteem, because I think that that's an issue that we've all dealt with severely, and I know that so many people deal with.
I guess I didn't realize how big of a problem self-esteem is.
We were in a mission trip in Venezuela. Well, we had done some of the songs from the new record, and you know, they liked them and everything, and then Kristen did Plain.
5 lines into the song, I think it was, we're in tears.
It wasn't just like one or two girls crying, it was like these huddled groups of girls crying.
It hit home with me and seeing these girls and how much self-esteem is needed to be talked about and dealt with. I think we all have those things that we criticize about ourselves and we want to change. We wanted them to know that, first and foremost, God, you are God's creation, and He loves you, and He has made you different and special and unique. I've been through it. I've definitely been through it, but I can say that I'm at a much better place in my life now. Proverbs 17 is a song. It's actually pulled from a true story about a girl in my hometown in New Jersey. She turned 17 and she got her driver's license, and a week later she was killed in a car accident. You never know what's going to come in life and the struggles you're going to go through.
You know, you're not guaranteed that you're going to make it to 18.
So we wanted that song on the album to really encourage kids to not take life for granted. Take every minute, you know, as it is, and thank God for it.
It turns out to be such a great song that really makes people think about, you know, the value of life.
I take each day as a blessing, and I thank God for another breath.
One beauty regimen I could not live without would be sunscreen, because I think if you don't preserve what you got, then all the rest of the products have no point.
I have to plug my eyebrows. I guess that would be the one. I had bushy eyebrows for too long, so. My MAC eyebrow pencil. When I was younger, I got a little happy, tweezer happy, and then I plucked most of my eyebrows off. And a lot of it never grew back, so I have this little handy pencil that I keep with me all the time.
When I get off the road after a run, the first thing I cannot wait to do is get in bed and either stare at the wall or stare at the TV.
I can't wait to fall on the floor and just go to sleep. I'm constantly thinking about my cat. First thing I do usually when I go in is just grab my cat and pick her up and love on her. And after every show, I pretty much collapse on the floor and I say, I quit. I do it all the time. It's kind of like a stress release. I don't know why.
amazing looking back on my life and how all the steps that God has brought me through. And I look back on a particular step that changed the course of my life, basically. And it was the night I became a Christian. And I went to a crusade. I thought it was a pop concert, but it turned out to be a Christian concert, and I heard the gospel, and I became a Christian that night. I never really understood who Jesus was and all that he did for me until that night, until somebody went out of their comfort zone and explained it to me. And I think about it now, and I think, you know, what if they never did that? What if that person just decided not to go to that, to do that concert that night, or just wanted to go home and watch TV? We're required to be bold. God wants us to be bold. You know, as he was bold for us, we need to be bold for him. Where would I be right now if that didn't happen? And so I just want to challenge everybody out there to never, ever back down. Even when you feel like it is going to not work, you know, that is not the truth. Anytime you feel that in your heart, don't deny that it's there, but go out and speak it. Speak the truth, because you never know who's going to listen and who's going to accept it. For those of you out there that maybe have never made that commitment to accept Christ, I want to encourage you right now. I want to be bold right now and say, do that today, because like we were saying earlier, nobody is guaranteed tomorrow. If you die tonight, do you know for sure where you would be going? And if you can't say that you know that answer, I want you to just think about this. It's as simple as ABC. All you have to do is A, admit the truth about yourself, that you are a sinner and that you do need a savior. B, believe in your heart that Jesus Christ is Lord, that he died on the cross for you. And C, confess your sins to him and commit your life to him. And I just want to also encourage you, D, to do it now, because nobody is guaranteed tomorrow. I'll see it once, I'll see it twice.